Good morning to everybody. Look at the exercise 10.4, second question. What it is given for you? If two equal parts of a circle intersect within a circle, prove that the line segments of one part are equal to the corresponding segments of the another part. So these are the two equal parts given. That is AB equal to CD. These are the two equal parts given that AB equal to CD. So intersect within a point, intersect within a circle at a point E. We are trying to prove that if the segment of one chord are equal to the corresponding segment of the another chord, that is AE equal to DE. To prove AE equal to DE, and second part you have to say that CE equal to BE. CE equal to DE. Am I right? Do you have any doubt in this? No. So this is given, AB equal to CD. What are we trying to prove? That AE equal to DE and CE equal to BE. That is, we are trying to prove that the segment of one chord are equal to the corresponding segment of the another chord. Are you getting here? Yes. Now, by construction we can do that. By construction, what we can do? Draw a perpendicular line. Name it as M. Then here, name it as N. That is what? Draw OM perpendicular to AB and OM perpendicular to CD. So we know that if the perpendicular line drawn from the center of circle to the chord, then it bisects the chord. Bisect means what? It divides into two equal halves. So it is given that AB equal to CD. Am I right? Yeah, it is given. So you can write like half of AB equal to half of CD. Am I right here? Yes. If the perpendicular line is drawn from the center of circle to the chord, it bisects the chord. So what is the meaning of that? AM equal to BM equal to half of AB. AM equal to BM equal to half of AB. Suppose this is a circle, this center O, this is a chord. If a perpendicular line drawn from the center of circle to the chord, it bisects the chord. So you can say that half of AB is nothing but AM equal to BM equal to half of AB. That is, half of AB can be written as AM equal to BM. Then this equal to half of CD. Half of CD is nothing but if the perpendicular line is drawn from the center of circle to the chord, then it bisects the chord. So what you can conclude that? Yes. CN equal to DN. What you can say here? CN equal to DN. Do you have any doubt in this? No. Now, we will consider these two triangles. Which two triangles? In triangle OEM and triangle OEN, we will try to prove these two triangles are congruent. Which two triangles are congruent? Triangle OEM and triangle OEN. So, in triangle OEM and triangle OEN. Shall we prove now? Yes, it's very simple. OEM, O, it is E, it is M, another one is OEM. Okay, done. Now, already we drawn OM is perpendicular to AB and OEM is perpendicular to CD. So it is 90 degrees each. After that, OEM is a common. And then we have to say one more part. What is that? Can you say that ME equal to AE? No, we cannot say. Right? Do you have any proof for ME equal to AE? No, we cannot say anything about ME equal to AE. Then, can we say anything about angle MOE equal to angle MOE? MOE, where is MOE? MOE equal to MOE? No, we cannot say. So, what we can say there? Yes. We can say that if the two perpendicular lines are drawn from the center to the equal parts, then they are equal in length. Are you getting or not? Yes. What can you say? Chords equidistant from the center. That is, AB and CD are the two chords, two equal chords. So so that they are equidistant from the center. So that they are equidistant from the center. Okay, now we will write angle OME equal to angle OME 90 degree each. Then OE OE common hypotenuse we can say. Then OM equal to ON. Since AB equal to CD, therefore equidistance from the center. Equidistance from the center. Are you getting here? Then, so by which congruence rule we can say that these two triangles are congruent? Yes, right angle, hypotenuse on one side. So by RHS congruence rule, you can say that by RHS congruence rule, you can say that triangle OME is congruent to triangle OME. OME is congruent to triangle OME. Am I right here? Yes. And then after that, what we can say that? Yes. ME equal to NE, you can say that. ME equal to NE. Am I right or wrong? Yes. ME equal to NE. Then, we know that AM equal to DN. AM equal to what? DN. Already we know. AM equal to DN. Let it be equation number 1. Let it be equation number 2. Am I right? Now, if you are adding 1 and 2, that is AM plus ME. AM plus ME. What it gives? Adding 1 and 2, it gives AM plus ME, that is equal to here DN plus ME. DN plus ME. DN plus ME. Alright? Now, AM plus ME means what? It gives AE. Here, why we are adding 1 and 2? If equals are added to the equals, then the wholes are what? Equal. If equals are added to the equals, then the wholes are equal. If equals are subtracted from the equal, then the remainders are equal. Then the remainders are equal. Are you getting? Yes. Here, what we did? AM equal to DN, then ME equal to NE. So, AM plus ME equal to DN plus ME. Are you getting clear? Now, come to my point. AM plus ME, it gives what? AE. AM plus ME, it gives what? AE. DN plus ME. Where is DN? DN is here, ME is here. So, it gives what? DE. It gives what? DE. So, this is the first part we proved here. AE equal to DE, we proved here. And then second part you have to say that CE equal to B. CE equal to B. Okay. Now, AB equal to CD already it is given for you. Am I right? AB equal to, let it be 3. Then AB equal to CD it is given, let it be 4. Are you getting here? That is AE equal to DE, we proved, let it be equation number 3. AB equal to CD, already given that two parts are equal. So let it be equation number 4. Now what I am going to do? Subtract the fourth equation, third equation from the fourth equation. That is fourth equation minus third equation. It gives AB minus DE equal to CD minus DE. CD minus DE. Am I right? Now, AB minus AE. From the whole, you are subtracting this AE. So, what are you getting? You are getting this segment, that is segment BE. That is, you are getting segment BE. So, if equals are subtracted from the equals, then the remainders are what? Equal. If equals are subtracted from the equal, then the remainders are what? Equal. So, AB minus AE, it gives from AB, you are subtracting AE, so we are getting BE. Here. Then, from the whole CD, from the whole CD, you are subtracting DE, we are getting CE. We are getting CE. Therefore, BE equal to CE. We completed the second part of the proof. BE equal to CE. Are you getting clear? It's a very simple concept. So, in the already I told you, in exercise 9.4, all the questions are very, very important for your examination point of view. Right? So once if you are clear in the concept, right, of circles, as well as statement theorem, statement as well as proof. Suppose if you don't know the proof also, you have to know about the what the theorem statement and what is the result, right? For example, if the perpendicular line drawn from the center of circle to the chord, it will bisect the chord. If the line drawn from the center of circle to the chord, it bisects the chord, then it is perpendicular to the center. Are you getting here? If the two chords are equal, then chords, if the two chords of a circle are equal, then the angles of tangent at the center of the circles are also equal. If the angles of tangent at the centers of the circles are equal, then the chords are equal. Are you getting here? Then what is the coordinate points? So these are all the concepts you have to, yes, no. Then only you can able to apply the theorem statement here and there. Okay, you see, AB equal to CD, here we written somewhere. Here only AB equal to CD. Here the two parts are equal, therefore equidistant from the center. Are you getting the concept here? That's all. So that tomorrow we will continue the next question in the exercise 10.4. Okay, so I am planning to do every day only two questions. I don't want to hurry up the syllabus. We will do slowly every day. We will do one or two questions per day. That's all. That much enough. Are you getting here? Yes. Then tomorrow we will continue the question number 3. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.